teachers, what's the worst situation you've returned to after leaving the classroom? Not a teacher, but in the 6th grade we had this English teacher who was always flying off the handle in a rage, and would slam her fist down on her metal podium like a gavel, so the kids would shut up and sit down. One day, the teacher left class for whatever reason, and another kid in my class quickly went up to the podium, and pulled out a screwdriver and quickly loosened every screw he could find on it, and sat back down. Lo and behold, the teacher came back and eventually found the kids to be too talkative, and slammed her fist down, and the whole podium fell to pieces. It was a hilarious sight to see, until the teacher started to cry. I felt bad, even if she was a mean old bitch. Well, I had to step out for a phone call about a student in class. I didn't want him to hear me talking about him, or any other students. This was when I was still working at a middle school, and have since moved on to high school. I thought it'd be a larger improvement than it was, but certainly haven't had a situation like the one I had in middle school so far. Anyway, I'm outside of the classroom for a maximum 1 minute. They all start talking, when I announce I have to leave the room for a moment and pause the lesson. I'm fine with that, but about halfway through my phone conversation all taking stops and it's perfectly silent. I come back in, and a kid is sitting on my desk with a stapler against his head, threatening that if his girlfriend, also in the class, doesn't get back together with him, he'll end it all right there. For some reason, maybe because it was early in the year of 7th grade and they are still young, she completely believes that if he presses that stapler against his head it's over. So she starts begging him to put the stapler down, and that she's sorry. While this was happening, I was basically letting it resolve itself because 1. I didn't think the kid had the balls to do it, and 2. The girl was trying to talk him down. The situation resolved itself, but I decided to send him to the principal's office, because it was not something he should be doing. I think the parents should be concerned, and I knew it would be hard to focus the class afterwards. While I'm walking him to the hallway to explain why I'm doing this, he screams, "Jennifer, I love you," and she started crying. Hormones are some crazy shit. My high school had this very old, like 70 plus year old man who taught economics, and also was the ICE teacher. He could be quite blunt. He'd been in a war or two, had his wife die literally in his arms in their kitchen, and didn't grow up well in Saudi Arabia. So he could be a bit harsh at times, but was generally hilarious, and loved by a lot of students. Except one student who got iced daily. So one day, while the old teacher had stepped out, the student got up, and mixed liquid cement into his coffee mug. He ended up in the hospital for a while but survived. Student obviously ended up arrested and in jail. Right, so. My old religious studies teacher collected water bottles. Like, loads of them. Her desk was absolutely swamped with them, and they proliferated over the 3 years I had her as a teacher. I counted them one day, and if I remember rightly, there were at least 25. Most of them had never been opened, and even the ones that had, were still mostly full. I remember when we started the topic of poverty and she opened the discussion with the old millions of children in Africa go without clean food and water, which the irony was not lost on. Eventually, we probed to find out why she kept all this water, and it took a while, but she told us. She was a religious woman, and it turned out she believed that when God turned her water into wine, she would retire. One day, she left the classroom for some time to speak to someone or other. Someone in our class just happened to have blackcurrant squash on him, so we added it to one of the water bottles to make it look like wine. When she came back to the room, she was obviously skeptical, but we all played along for the rest of the lesson and even afterwards. I didn't think she was really convinced, but she did indeed retire at the end of the year, and whether it was by divine providence or if we just annoyed her that much isn't for me to say. Last year, while I had to do quick photocopies for the kids who forgot their documents, one of my grade 10 tripped and made a hole in the wall. It wouldn't be too bad if in their great teenager's mind, they didn't decide to make the hole bigger. I came back when they were figuring out if they could hide one of them in it. I was torn between laughter and anger. When I was in middle school, I had this classmate who really liked electricity. The more destructive forms of it. He always carried around this DIY shorting plug and he used to plug it into the school's sockets when no teacher was looking. One time, the computer class teacher left the classroom for some reason. Once he did that, the classmate got to do his thing. He plugged his plug into a socket, interrupting my UD 2004. I think it was a 2004. A version of Unreal Tournament, anyways, match. And then he confidently walked up to the breaker panel, reset the breaker, and failed to restore the power. As it turns out, the breaker failed to do its job, and the guy's feat of circuit shorting actually burned cable in the school's electrical system. He was not punished for it either. None of us reported him. Snitches do get so-called stitches after all, and if the teacher had reported him, well, he'd have admitted to leaving a class full of students and full of computer equipment completely unattended. So he didn't. During my last 2 years of high school, a new high school was being built to replace our current one. We did the first half of the year in the old school, then during Christmas break they tore down the old school, turned the space into the new parking lot, and we returned after the break to the new school. On the last day before Christmas break, everyone was in see to take part in the destruction of our 70-year-old, asbestos-filled high school. My history teacher left the room, and all hell broke loose. A couple kids started bashing chairs into the wall, breaking big chunks of it down, and creating a huge hole in the wall between our classroom and the neighboring one. Kids were running back and forth between the two classrooms, while others were trying to stick as many chairs as they could in the wall. Soon after this started, the chaos began spreading to the rest of the school. Kids were running through the halls yelling, bashing lockers and throwing papers. It was insane. Meanwhile, the VP was losing his mind on the intercom ordering everyone to stop. The teacher came running back in pretty quickly and everyone stopped, but the damage was done, and a lot of the damaged stuff was stuff that was supposed to be transferred over to the new school. When I was in 8th grade, my teacher had to step out for a phone call and everyone started talking amongst themselves. This kid was sitting in the seat closest to the door with his back to it, and right as my teacher opened the door to come back in, he stood on his chair and yelled, "I may be a skinny Indian kid, but I have a dick the size of Jupiter." He didn't see my teacher initially, but when everyone bursted out laughing and pointing at my teacher, who was now just standing there staring at him, he noticed and got super red. To this day I have no idea why he felt the need to announce that to the whole class, and without him knowing, my teacher. Not a teacher, but I've got a few stories. In 8th grade, a kid stuck a pencil in an electrical socket on the side of one of those science class tables with the outlets built in. Teacher came back and found him crying in a fetal position and everyone else pretending to read. In 11th grade AP history, we had a really cool teacher. She left the room to watch another class. We were AP students, so we were supposed to be more mature. While she was gone, we turned out the lights and hid in the corner of the room she couldn't see because of how the window on the door was shaped. It looked like we left. Dumb, but she thought it was funny. Senior year in health class, the teacher was also the football coach and was going back and forth between our class while we were taking a test and the locker room to monitor repairs that were being made. One kid stood on the desk to dance, be funny, and the desk collapsed. He laid there on the floor crying while we pretended to take our tests. My high school biology teacher had a father in the IQ who was basically going through some major surgery and the odds of survival were low. She had her cell phone, which was a little flip phone that only got cell signal if placed in the windowsill of the window furthest from her desk, and was waiting for the hospital to call when he was out of surgery. Some third child stole her phone when she went to get copies from the printer down the hall. My 7th grade class spent a week messing with one teacher. I'm not sure why she kept leaving us alone. I think she may have had another class before ours where she had to be on the other side of campus. The first day, we hid in the workroom attached to her room, so she walked into an empty classroom. The second day, one student hid under her desk until halfway through the class, when she went to sit down, when he grabbed her ankle. The third day, we were all sitting at a normal chair connected to desks, with the whole unit flipped upside down. The fourth day, everyone whose desk was in front of a window had their legs hanging out the window and their heads stuck through, so they looked like they were sitting at their desks, but were halfway outside. The last day of the week, when she got there, we were all sitting in our normal seats, upright and in their normal rows, lined up outside on the walkway leading to the classroom. Joke was on us, though. She was accompanied by the dean of discipline. Back in year 10th, 13-14 years oldish, we had a fresh English teacher. completely new to the profession and quite young, early 20s. This teacher wasn't a strong person and our class was known as one of the worst in the school. She'd get bullied and react poorly to it, essentially making it get worse. One time she left the room and someone blew up a condom and we started batting it around. She entered back into the room and started screaming for us to stop. Obviously we didn't. She started following it around the room trying to get it. After a few minutes she gave up and went to get someone higher up. So in comes an assistant head teacher. Right, pop that balloon right now. For some reason her calling it a balloon caused us to erupt into laughter. She eventually got the condom and popped it, and then took over teaching the class for the rest of the lesson. We didn't have the English teacher again much after that. Obligatory, not a teacher, but was in the class. This was kind of intentional chaos. We were a GT, gifted and talented, class that combined app English and history. We were about to start a unit on Lord of the Flies, and to create a demonstration on human nature our teacher told us she was giving us free rein of the classroom for, I don't recall, 20 minutes? Sure enough, it was chaos. Two teams formed, and leaders took their positions as butcher paper was ripped, and made into weapons slash projectiles and desks were stacked to create walls of defense. Thankfully we were good enough kids to not do anything that couldn't be easily undone or actually hurt anyone. Pretty damn cool experience when you follow it up with Lord of the Flies and see that those kids basically did the exact same thing without adult supervision. We had a substitute teacher that none of the students liked. He was a bully. I somehow managed to excuse myself to go to the bathroom and came back to absolute carnage. First thing I noticed, that the tables and chairs had been thrown all over the place and there was another teacher restraining a student and the substitute was on the floor with a bloody nose. The other students were all stood around the room shocked. We were asked to go down to the library and not go to our other classes for the rest of the day whilst it was dealt with and the teachers took witness statements from the students. I found out later from another teacher and a few friends that the substitute had mocked him over his father's very recent death that happened less than a week beforehand, and the student snapped and went for him. Taking notice and finally listening to our complaints, the substitute wasn't allowed back to the school and the student got a one-day suspension. In my Latin class last year, the teacher left the room for about 20 minutes. She was trying to figure out how to copy some worksheets. She was a really shitty teacher, and hardly knew English let alone Latin. Yeah, she was pretty low on the IQ scale. Anyway, while she was gone, everyone started taping random objects to the walls. Hand sanitizer bottles, water bottles, pencil holders, pencils, and even a bag with a sandwich in it. She came back and everyone acted like nothing happened. She didn't even notice what happened, and the class absolutely lost it when she was trying to look for a pen. One of the braver students even got up and got a squirt of hand sanitizer from the wall. Not a teacher, but the school was debating removing our lockers and forcing us to have clear backpacks. The entire student body was in an uproar, all 4,000 kids. The principal agreed to a debate with the student council president, who was also captain of the debate team and an absolute beast. When he found out this fact, he said he would only debate if questions were submitted in advance. The students disagreed, and he called it off. 2 days later, probably 97% of the students showed up with clear backpacks and a strip of duct tape over our mouths, all organized by our amazingly charismatic student council president. We kept it on all day and into the next day until they finally relented and told us they wouldn't institute the policy. Our class president was amazing. It's a shame he ended up a meth junkie at 23 and died in a robbery. Not a teacher, but in my Algebra 2 class we had a teacher that literally couldn't control any class. We came into class from second block to third, only to find the teacher duct taped to her chair. Apparently the football douche and his friends in her low-level math class walked up with questions only to duct tape her to the chair. Only the one kid that did it got a suspension, but I remember our class would play hide and seek with her. One student runs out of the portable, so the teacher chases them. Wait 15 seconds, then the next kid runs out and hides outside. First kid comes back, and teacher just says she upset they did that, only to come to the realization that another kid has fled. This process repeated during testing time, so myself and another kid, Joe, would finish our tests and pass them around the class. It was not a productive period.